Hello friends, welcome to the Python video series. In this video, we are going to talk about different data types available in Python. There are data types like numbers, strings, printing, lists, dictionaries, booleans, tuples, and sets, which are available in Python. So here we are going to talk about first two data types, that is numbers and strings. Remaining data types we are going to see in the next videos. So to start with, I am using Anaconda distribution and Jupyter notebook. If you want more information about creating the environment for Python or installing Anaconda and using Jupyter, please write down me in the comment. I will try to create a separate video for the same. So to start with, let's start with the numbers data type. So basically there are two number data types available in Python, that is integers and floating point. So this is integer. Now floating point is also available in Python. So you can do different operations. For example, addition you can do. If I want to go for division, I can use this sign. Okay. So you can see the result. It's 2.0. In earlier version it was not supported, but in Python 3 now it is possible. You can go for another operations also. Arithmetic operations. The point to note here is, for example, I want to do exponentiation, for example 2 raised to 4. So this is a notation which is used for exponentiation, that is star star. So it is going to give me 2 raised to 4, that is 16. For remainder, it uses the same sign, that is percentage 4 mod 2. It is going to show me the remainder, that is 0. For example, 5 mod 2, it will show you remainder. Okay. Now to move forward, what we will see next is we will see variable assignment. So this hash is actually used for comment in Python. For example, we are going to discuss variable assignment. If I run it using shift enter, so there is nothing happened actually, because this hash is actually a comment. Now if I want it as a plain text, what I can do is I can go here and I can click on markdown, and if I run it using shift enter, now you can see it is like a plain text. So that can also be done. You can use it for your for writing some important points or for writing down notes in Jupyter notebook. That is also possible. So to start with variable assignment, the point to remember here is, in Python you cannot start with you cannot start variable name with a number or special character. For example, if I write on a variable name like this, so it is going to show me error. You can check it. It's showing me syntax error. This is not possible because it is starting with number, so that is not allowed in Python. Another is, I cannot use any special character at the start of the variable name also. That is also not possible. So it is also going to show me error. The right way to use or the recommended way to give a variable name is use underscore. For example, name underscore var is equal to 78. So it is not going to show me any error in this case. It is going to work. So if possible, try to use underscore for variable name, for declaring variables. Okay. Otherwise, you can use variable names like this also. X is equal to 7, Y is equal to, for example, 9, and you run it. If I write on X is equal to, suppose X plus X. So now X will be 7 plus 7 is 14. If I write on it once again, X is equal to X plus X. So it is going to show me the latest value, that is 28. Okay. So that is about numbers data type. Now what we will do is we will move to next data type, that is string. So for example, I have a string S is equal to This is a string I have, S is equal to hello. Now, if I want the first character, I can do it like this, S of 0. If I write it down like this, S of 0 colon, this is called as slice indexing. So it is going to show me starting from 0 till end. So till O, that is H-E-L-L-O. If I do it like this, S of 4, and shift enter, it is going to show me the last character. So the point you can note here is it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So always remember the location starts from 0 in string. Now if I have s1 is equal to a string like a, b, c, d, e, f, g, h, I, j, k, this is a string I have, this is s1. Now obviously s1 of 0, it is going to show me the first character, that is a. If I write on it like this, s1 of 0 colon, it is going to show me the complete string, right? If I write on s1 of colon 3, so it is going to show me from 0th location, then 1 and 2, it is going to show me ABC only. Remember, it is going to exclude the third character, this will not be shown. So the output of this will be A, B, and C only. So this is very, very important. Now if I try to combine both, s1 of 0 colon 3, so it is also going to show the same result, that is A, B, C. You can check it here. Okay. Now what if I want D, E, F? What should I write down here? So you can write it down like this. I want D, E, F, right? So D, E, F means 0, 1, 2, 3. So D is starting from 3. So 3, 4, 5 and 6 also I will have to include. That is how Python behaves. So it will be 3 colon 6. So 6 location, the character which is at the 6th location, that will not, that will be excluded. That means this G will not be there. It will be DEF only. So let's check. Right. So this is a very, very important point to remember for strings in case of Python. Now to move to next use of strings, I can use variables in sentences also. For example, if I write on A is equal to 50 and for example B is equal to some string like whether it on my name. Okay, so these are the two variables we have, A and B. Now I will write on some string like my my number is, for example, I want the first value here. So what I will do is I will put curly bracket here and my name is, again put one more curly bracket and use dot format in Python and provide the variables in the same sequence which you want. So what I want is I want 50 here and Yogesh Murugkar here. So according to that sequence I have provided A and B. Now you run it with shift enter. Now you can check my number is 50 and my name is Yogesh Murugkar. What you can do is you can use print, and inside print you can use the same thing, that is I'm going to write down whatever I have done in the upper cell. My number is again curly bracket and my name is again curly bracket. So that single quote should be complete here and now dot format. So what will happen because of this is in the output you are not going to see these quotes if you use print, because you are using print here. So let's check. So you can check the output is same, but there are no single quotes here. So that is because of this print. Another way to use this string in this one is, for example, if I write on the same thing, print, and or I will make the changes here only. What I will do is instead of this A and B, what I will do is I will provide two new variables here, 1 and 2. What I will have to do, I will have to write it down like this: 1 is equal to A and 2 is equal to B. So again it is going to show me the same output. Now what if I want to use the same variable again and again? So that also can be done. Use a keyword called as more and provide curly brackets here, and inside that curly bracket provide the variable name. For example, I will write down 2 here, so that is, what is the value for 2? B. And what is the value for B? Yogesh Murugkar. So this Yogesh Murugkar will be there 2 times. So let us run it so you can check. Right. Now so this is how you can use these two basic data types, that is numbers and strings. So remaining data types like printing, lists, dictionaries, booleans, tuples and sets, and all other complex programs about Python, and all the basic things about Python we are going to talk about in the next coming videos. So that's it from my side for now. Thank you very much, friends.